I will. I guess it's my time to go, right?
Do it.
Hey, well, seriously though, on a serious note, I don't think I even introduced myself now that I think about it. I'm over here close to the end, and I'm over here getting ready to introduce myself. Anyway, I go by brother Vessel, and I'm gonna do this a little bit different. I'm gonna do my songs first, and then I'm gonna give you all my testimony and why I go by the name Vessel. With Kingdom Music, I'm not sure if any of y'all are familiar with my brother Brian and Monica out of Kingdom Music.
Yeah.
Woo woo. So, you know, God bless them because they were actually vessels to me that brought me to Christ. And funny thing is that it took a YouTube video for me to watch, and I was I was on it one day, and y'all, I don't know if y'all know, sometimes it gives y'all the option where it says we recommend this video.
Yeah.
And God was working through YouTube that day. And it came up, and I'm sitting there looking, I'm like, okay, this little Hispanic dude, bald-headed, tattooed, he's rapping, let me see what he's about. Little did I know that this little bald-headed Hispanic dude is about to get ready to say, help me save my life.
Amen.
So, with that, I want to go ahead and... got some songs for y'all. Why don't you go ahead and join with me? We praise our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's go ahead and get this, and then after that, I'm gonna give y'all my testimony in Jesus' name. Nothing. doing. No sinning. It's just serenity. Total serenity. Grace, love, passion. It's the title of this next track. It's called Serenity.
I will worship you. Experiencing the hustle and all that came in the game. It started out with attitude.
Chances in the past. What makes you think I'm gonna give you another one? Someone change. Again, actions speak louder than words. So that's where we go, our family trip in the summer, and I roll into the video on YouTube, our brother Brian. And I could tell at that point in time, something was changing inside of me. It was moving like a wheel, just continually keeping moving and moving. And it started, I started understanding. And it got my interest. I'm like, okay. We got back, fast forward to August. We started attending this brand new church, and the one I'm going to is in Richland Hills. It's called Gateway. I've never experienced a church like this before. Walked in, I've never experienced worship, and I've never seen the realism people give you, even from the door greeter, he's being genuine, smiling at you, holding his hand out, wanting to shake your hand, wanting to hug you. I'm like, what's wrong with these people? I've never experienced that. I used to come from a Catholic church. The majority of Hispanic men and women growing up, we grow up because it's traditional. I would sit there and I'm like, service almost over? I'm not getting it. I wasn't being fed. When I went into this church, I understood every single word the pastor was saying. And I was receiving it. Amen. I was taking notes. I'm like, this is something I'll never do. Yeah. So I'm over here doing all this, and then worship music hit again, and they were doing altar call. And it hit me. The Holy Spirit was like, this is what needs to happen. The Lord, your will be done. Grab my wife's hand, and we both surrendered at that point in time. Going forward, amen, I never looked back. Yeah. So what I do afterwards, I still kept the name Frio. I'm still rolling on with Frio and stuff like that. God hit me one evening. He says, my son, it's still my will for you to continue to do music. I want you to take some time off to get discipled. And I went through this 6-month program of Kingdom Music to be discipled, getting to know what the word of the Bible was and just enjoying it. And he told me, he goes, all right, my son, it's time. But I want you to get rid of the name Frio. It's too much sin attached to it. Too much that you've done, too much that has happened in the past, and we're no longer living in the past, but looking forward. And I said, Lord, so what do you want me to go by? He says, I want you to go by the word, I want you to go by the name Vessel. And I'm thinking, the heck is Vessel? So me, the smart person that I am, I get on Google, and I say to Google, Google, what does vessel have to do with the word Bible, with the Bible? First result that I got, 2 Timothy 2:21. And I'm sorry, I'm still not great as far as memorizing scripture. I'm learning it, but I'm going to paraphrase it for you. 2 Timothy 2:21 pretty much states that you being a newborn creation, for every good deed that you do for the Lord, I want you to be a vessel for me. Going out, and I want you to do every good deed in my name because you are a new creation. And I was stunned. I said, Lord, you do exist. And all these people that sit there, you hear about in the world that have so much just hatred toward him, or they just don't even want to get the opportunity to know him. He's real. So with my past that I've been going through, I gave up music for 6 months. God said, you know what? I want to put it back in your life. But we're going to do it like those three servants that I said earlier in the book of Matthew. I want you to be a servant of the Lord. And with that, here we are, being able to share my music with you, minister to you through music. Again, it's ministry over music, because music's nothing but a tool. But at the end of the day, you know what? As long as we all are continued in the love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, no weapon formed against will ever prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus. So with that, I just want to go ahead and I want to open up the altar right now. Haven't had the opportunity to really get to know who our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is, I invite you right now, because going through life without Jesus, honestly, I mean, the best way to put it is just say, you're walking through like you're just going through the motions. You don't know what life is like until you know the Lord and Savior. And I just ask you, if you feel led right now, or even if you just need to speak with somebody right now, I ask my ministry team, I ask Brother Mike to come down, I ask M.O.G. to come down, I ask Brother Lee Green to come down. If anybody needs prayer for any particular reason, I ask them to come to us, because right now it's about healing. It's about healing through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because that is what he's here for. He's here to be able to come and just reach out, touch you, and heal you. So I just ask, if y'all need healing today, if y'all need the opportunity to
get to know who our Savior Jesus Christ is and ask Him and fully submit to Him and to have that true love that He is able to provide, ask you to come down. Or even if you don't come down, if you catch one of us having service, just come down, just talk with one of us. We'll be more than happy to pray for you. In Jesus' name. Thank you, everybody that came out this evening. I just want to tell y'all thank you for coming out and just sharing this experience that we have as ministers to come out and show the real world of what the gospel is all about in our special talent that was provided. So I love y'all. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you very much.